I said good day, sir!
Welcome, everybody, into your coverage of the defense, season number 3. I am Toby Wan Kenobi. Actually, if you didn't know, I was over in Malaysia recently casting both SM and the last big Dota 1 tournament, probably for me, as well as also the Asia, which was one of the big Dota 2 tournaments over there. Of course, while I was gone, the defense games were going on, and some of them actually missed a couple of casters. So because of that, you know what? We're going to go back into the old archives and see what it is that we can cast. Of course, one of the games which missed out in the cast was ICC Cup going up against Mouse Sports. So, hey, you know, there's this wonderful thing called Dota TV. It's exactly what we're going to use for your absolute viewing pleasure right now. So let's jump ourselves over into the game and do this very, very quickly. You guys are going to enjoy this one. This is draft at high speed, basically, because we don't have to wait, because we've obviously got a little, well, actually, you can't see the box at the top right corner right now, and I'll remove it for mainly inside the game, but you guys love this when I jump over the draft, so we're going to do that right now and just see basically what we've got and see what we're moving at. Remember, this was a couple of weeks ago, so it's changed around a little bit as far as the metagame, as far as the entire game looks. So, yeah, this is going to be a little bit more different, but we get to see Kuro's Wisp. We get to see Undying as well coming out in the pool. Would you believe NA, still, no matter what happens, he's still being picked up. I see Cup going to take him with a lot of burst damage through Shadow Demon and Queen of Pain. And this puts well, Nakes as well. So what happens if you're doing going up against a whole bunch of magical damage and people like to interrupt what you're doing? You just give Black a Lifestealer. He's able to do a lot of damage with that. And then Lashrak, Ruby just trying to ban out. And that's, they're mainly looking at heroes that are going to combine up with the Wisp more than likely. Even though it could still be the Undying, but yeah, at this stage of the game, they're looking to bring three people around the map. Wow, this is just like, the announcer can't keep up with this one. It's beautiful. I love it. It's fantastic. Let's go with that. We're also not going to use directed camera at all. And Viper pickup from Mouse Sports. By the way, I actually haven't seen any of these games. And you give me a Weaver as well. I love this. And Clockwork Goblin being the last one coming in for Mouse Sports. They get a really good offlaner hero through that Clockwork Goblin. Ever since he got that rocket buff and the way the four-star interacts with the power cogs, he's a lot better as a hero. But yeah, this is actually, yeah, I haven't seen any of these games, guys. Haven't watched a single iota of them because I've just been insanely busy and also overseas. So I don't know anything which is going to happen in this game. If you are in the same boat as me, then congratulations. Welcome to Mouse Sports versus ICC Cup. So running through very, very quickly, who's got what? So for ICC Cup, we'll run through them first. So FNG, he'll be as the Keeper of Light. J4 up as that NA. Axe will be the stand-in player by the looks of it, taking up the role as Queen of Pain. We just sick will be the Shadow Demon heading up towards that top lane. And that leaves our last one, which is Sunlight. Sunlight coming in as the Weaver. And that is our final lineup now. Over towards Mouse Sports, because you know these guys are a lot better. So Black, he'll be taking that Nakes up towards the top lane. Going to be supported by Alex, taking up that role as Undying. Always support man, always love watching his Jakiro play. But in this case, he will be taking up that role as the Undying support. Over towards the middle lane, and it's going to be Fater. He's always that solo mid player for Mouse Sports. And he'll be taking up the role as the Viper in this scenario. Kuro, I said it was his Kuro when I saw the Wisp pick up, which is obviously no surprise whatsoever. He'll be taking up that Wisp role. And that leads past the offlane player to play the Clockwork Goblin. He's just scouting it to see who was really around where. Maybe drop Axe down a little bit lower earlier on. Yeah, there goes the rocket, but Axe just walks straight over the top of it. Takes no damage whatsoever. But it's going to be a gross tri-lane up on top. SD, Coddle, and NA. And maybe you can find Blackout very, very early on. He's looking for that invis room, which is already now stolen by We Just Sick. And he can keep on going if he wants. Disruption already used. Follow-up with a double stun through Alex. And Kuro, with a very quick pause. On the bright side about this, guys. Sorry, DC'd. Ready? 4x the pace. No waiting for pauses when you do replay mode. Oh man, I love this. Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. Knew that was going to happen. And no kill just yet. We Just Sick on the run. And there's a lot of support that came in very, very quickly. And that's going to be the death. We Just Sick able to take it. Kuro, so easy once you're able to tether up with Black. And then, well, there's our disconnection now. And that's going to be NA DCing out. who obviously isn't the best guy considering he's currently in the middle of this engagement. So let's not jump up to 8 times the pace. I'm happy with 2 times the pace. That way that doesn't happen again. Yeah. But this is going to be just a little bit more of a time while NA is being disconnected back out again. But just losing that Shadow Demon very early on. The second you get Kuro with a tether, and that's one of the beautiful things about Kurokai as a player and a captain. He knows where he's got to be at exactly the right time. And by tethering himself in, you get that line right, you're able to get that perfect tether off. And he's one of those guys, too, that always likes to couple up with anything that's possible. Like, even saw him, I think it was him that was doing it at the WCG, where they combined him up with Shadow Demon, so the disruption came out, and then he would tether himself to one of the illusions. And because the disruption illusion standing right next to the hero, it was a guaranteed tether stun, so he just lapped that up. Absolutely lapped it up. Kuro and Alex just staring down on J4 right now. Some decent time. Let's just buff this one. See, I know it's going to happen again. Four, sup. No, not back again. Wait for that reconnect thing to come. And we'll just go up to 8. Yeah, 8. Yeah, bringing up that rating point. But this is going to be still a little bit of extra time. But hey, time flies when you're having 8x speed. Doesn't it now? Doesn't it? Now, this is only 19 seconds into the game. Whoop, there's a reconnect. So back down to 2. Fader says, are you ready? And, whoop, Axe says no. So, yep. We'll wait a little bit longer before we're good and ready to rock and rumble for this one. Looks like not many people enjoyed this game. I wonder if there was just a whole bunch of, like, fans of the team that lost. It's like, no, I don't like this game. The game was horrible. Viper was played. Kuro played it. Wait, no, that's not right. It was Fader. Oh. Instant downvotes. All right, so now they're good to go. So, whoops, back down to one time space, and then double stun. Gonna go through Black as well as Alex, but they got again that tether stun. Nice coddle blast, but it's 3 heroes sharing the damage across the board. And is there an open wound in 3 seconds time? And a decay. This should be the life of FNG gone. Open wounds. They need the vision. Nice salve timing going up the hill. So he's able to live, but used every single consumable apart from those 3 tangos he's got. But it was the salve anyway. And Black walks in and buys himself up a poor man shield. He'll wait for Kuro to heal him up with the tether. Yeah, there's the tether, and then sharing the heal over. So Black can feel very, very happy with himself. And then open wounds going again on Connell. Alex in from the side. Disruption by a little bit of time, but the decay's already had its effect. And then it actually buys time for the tether stun to work. And then the double impale again from the NA. But still not able to get the kill. Kuro tethers again. Wants Alex to get on the other side. Already now, magic stick charges. Keeping him alive, but down to 17 HP. And back to safety. Now Kuro will tether with Black and pop that salve. Yep. And Black goes back up to full life. They keep these consumables flying in. Or at least they can do so with all these kills going their way. Already 3-0. Let's get rid of that. And even just sharing the heal over towards Alex. Everything is split between these guys. They keep themselves alive. How's our other lanes looking? So pass on the bottom lane. 4-for-2 up against Weaver, who has no surprise at all, is 7-for-2, has the advantage. In towards the middle lane, Fader, 8-for-4, up against the Queen of Pain, who's 4-for-2, looks like Ace, copying a lot more harassment, even though he hasn't had to use that salve just yet. It's just Fader, who looks like he's been pulled a little bit, putting that Wraith Band on him. Kind of reminds you of those days, pulling that Wraith Band in towards the middle lane with a couple of consumables, and then just, like, owning anything you can possibly find, talking about a Morphling, actually. Yep, you know who I'm talking about. Obviously, because I just told you. But 0-for-3 up on the board. Quap, a little extra harassment again. Careful how low he gets, too. You know, that Nether Toxin loves to have a crack. And Black, not really feeling too confident up here on the top lane. Maybe because this is happening right now. Alex already pulled through. So he knows the creep wave's going to come in, so no reason to put himself in any kind of danger. Oh, there goes Fader. He's not going to tick. Tango charge to keep him alive. Buy some boots anyway. He can buy also a little bit of extra consumables, buy himself a salve, and fly it out to him. If this courier is actually flying out here with no salve, that's kind of stupid. But and it's flying out here with a ring of protection instead. So he's building up, and that is actually not his his full ring of a cooler just yet. Really surprised, though, he did not buy that salve. It's tranquil boots, that's the reason why. Yeah, wake up and smell the roses, Toby. The reason why that ring was already on him. So he's able to deal with all the harassment now from the Queen of Pain, able to dish it straight back again. I've just got morphling in my head for that Ring of Aquila. And then pass up against the Weaver on the bot lane. And Alex. A lot of space to move here. Walls from the Radiant side, keeping some nice deep vision in. And I can't draw on the map in Dota TV. Fail! Alex still wants to move in. Maybe Black, open wounds, gonna go on We Just Sick. Yep, Decay starting off, he's gonna disrupt himself if he wants back out again. There's all the trap, no, J4, able to get that tether, but then open wounds means then disruption forced out in him. The tether's perfectly in the right lines, and the Decay ensures the kill. You got the extra soul rip from Alex if they need to stay alive, if someone drops a little bit too low. So another heal coming their way. And Fade are really controlling up this mid lane. Looking for Ace and Ace, whoop, nice blink. Manages to avoid that little poison charge and then finds himself a regen rune too. So unless Fade is able to really finish him off here, there's no point in harassing him any further. Magic wand and still holding onto that Wraith Band. But no boots coming the way of... It's just showing boots. He's got the Tranquil boots going his way, but not starting to go over the treads. No extra attack speed coming his way. There's Ace who's actually got no boots whatsoever. But not always 100% required with Quap, but you use those that blink anyway. Now, again, such a simple combination to destroy him. You're two in the stun, but the Decay drops you down so far. Weaver will actually get a kill on bottom lane. Looks like help from the Shadow Demon with the disruption. Yeah, you know English. And Ace dead in the middle lane. Fader, just so easy. It's like ulti did most of the damage. Then follows through with two right clicks and Nether Tox, and already up at 3 points. So bonus damage, 120, just flying out. Always depends though. But he was pretty damn low. And now we see at the point, 1 for 7, IC Cup. The only kill they've got so far is down this Weaver, who at this point does look like he's building up towards, and I hope to God it's not, a Lincoln Spear. The reason why I say I hope to God is... Nah, cut a path. The only reason why I say I hope it's not is because it's such a defensive item up against a team that is just so aggressive. Like, even though there's not many targeted spells straight away, like, he'll trigger open wounds, they're sure that's great, but it's just not going to be the right thing to go for in this lineup. In fact, he just needs... You know, do you go with your magic immunity when you're going up against such high physical damage and you know you're going to lose all your life points straight away? Vanguard might be the best solution. J4, pass, actually holding him in there. One quick stun, we just stick going to come in and help out, but gets pushed away by the cogs. And pass runs out through the bottom, and it's a trap. Weaver's already here waiting for him, and he decides to turn around. He wants to come in with Fader. Fader just focusing on Weed, just sick. Rockets to fly as well. Not enough poison to kill him off. And now they move over to Weaver. Time lapse, he'll have to do it. Back down the river. And Weed is sick, lucky to escape from that one. At the same time, Kuro trying to chase down the Keeper of the Light. Combining up with Black. Can't go past this tower too easily. Black is going to be the one to tank it up, and Kuro gets a little bit of extra movement speed running up with him. That'll be level 5 now for Kuro. Alex chilling on the top. And then Keeper of the Line. Again, it's such a nice position there to hold off that creep wave. A little bit of extra damage to Black. Doesn't really put himself in too much danger unless this happens. And then Alex like, well, I know he's here. Like, where is he? Trees, trees. Yeah, there we go. Quick decay. Follow him down. And then he runs west. Wisp, no ulti just yet. So Kuro can't come and help him out. And then Alex might actually get himself a little bit of trouble too. Axe coming in from the side. Decay's already started off. So there's a lot of life there for Alex, but not enough to live. Not with a Quap ulti. And then the rotation down towards the bottom lane. IC Cup looking for an opening. And it's going to be pretty easy to find one on pass. It's not as though he's got any kind of escape mechanism or mana in this case. He's got absolutely nothing in him. And we just sick in J4, waiting for that time to initiate. Fed having to deal with a couple of fakes. Well, Ice continues to try and bottle up here in the mid. He has a lot of mana for that combo. Surprising too, like he's got those points up, like 2 points up in Sting. Most of the time you won't really hunt for a kill, but it was just a silver platter opportunity when Alex searched out for him. And obviously searching out for that top lane instead. But you kind of want to have the 4 points up in Scream and then the 1 point up in the Sonic Wave. Really surprising how long these guys have been waiting off on the side. Pass just walks around with an Invis rune. soaking up the experience, doesn't have to worry about anything. He's got no mana to do anything. Now he's got actually one rocket or a set of cogs. So the choice is his for what he wants. And the second he pops anything, J4 and we just stick in a rotate. Yep, there it goes. Rocket and Weaver Wave. Misses out in pass though, but there's more than enough support to kill him off. Disruption going to go. TP support going to come in. Nope, not going to happen. They just accept the fact that Pass will die in the bottom lane. 3 euros to do so. Maybe he won't. Maybe he will. He should. Yep, there's a jump in. But Weaver! It's just Dire's bottom tower is under attack. I don't know. I just don't know. FNG's going to go down the top lane. Black's just an easiest chase off after. And then infest through. Hand of Midas in him too. So more farm coming his way. Whoop, hello, Undying. Chasing down one, already picked up the Shadow Demon, now moving on to J4, who moves past the Tier 2 tower in the mid, and gets the creep wave, and that's another kill. Decay, stick charges, decay, and down to 454 life points. Alex doesn't have much more, but Fader with one right click will get the kill. Rocket from Glock, snipes it. And then back up to top, where Black finishes off the Tier 1 tower. Man, this is just... this is Mouse Balls controlling every single inch of this map. We just sick gonna head up towards the top lane. He'll be able to hold off Mouse Sports for the time being. Looks like Axe. Well, maybe they think they can bring down Black, but Black, he's got no TP scroll, but he's got 4 points up in Rage. It's the longest BKB ever for a guy. Yep, there goes the Rage. Starts opening up on Shadow Demon. He's gonna try and kill him off. This is Black just realizing he's gonna die with 4 heroes chasing him off. That's done way too early, and then 3 men on the tether, and the spear is 2. Quapaldi doesn't get anything. It went past everything. And then the tether stones continue. Finally, it gets 1 kill off. Kuro will go down. No, he won't. He gets pulled. He actually uses ulti to escape. Naze, can he buy back? Yes, he can, and he should. 350 gold, buy back and go with Kuro. They're coming back in again. Fader's already here. Kuro TP's in. And now, maybe a Soul Rift keeps him alive. He's on the run. Spirits to fly too. Fader's looking to bring down Weed. Just a couple more right clicks. Blink up. Alex manages to find one. While Fader takes care of all the supports. Look at that damage. One more right click. One more. No, it's going to poison. No, it's not. 18 HP. And Axe goes down. Alex finds him with one last decay. Really surprised that Black just didn't buy back and come with him. The buyback was there for him. And it's Mouse Sports, it's what they do. They always buy back prematurely. Maybe just that communication not working. Dire's structures are fortified. And Fader gonna chill in the mid lane. Nope, hello clockwork, initiating on the bottom. Dire's Weaver, he's still got time lapse if he needs to, which he will now use. And Pass puts up the blocking cogs. Sunlight trying to walk his way around it. Then gets spotted out. Fader will take care of that mid lane for the moment. And then up towards that top Black. As well as NA. Chilling, but look at Kuro already making that move. 4 seconds time, 3 seconds time before he's got ultimate. And remember, you can take 3 with it. Just infest into the Wisp, or whoever's coming with the Wisp. And jump straight back out again. It's basically gank train. And Kuro's tethered up. Is he going to go somewhere? Look for an opening. He needs to have vision, though, before he goes on somebody. J4 is going to be that kind of vision. They've got one ward up on the high ground. That's if they want to actually engage in the mid. Like, you see that level of sight. Just cuts the line. Oops, I can't draw again. Damn, I got to remember that. Rocket sees, though. So Rocket for vision, and then Whis just ultis in with anybody he wants. And with Black, it's basically a guaranteed kill. Well, J4. Oh, sorry, S4. No, J4. Middle lane. Rockets again out in ace. Now will be that time to TP in for Wisp. A lot of heroes coming in. There's a TP actually coming towards the middle lane. And that's going to be Pass coming in looking for the ultimate. Linus riding. He can actually latch up Alex. Whoop! Paused by Pass. They lost Viper in the middle of the game. It's the reason why Viper's caught out of position. So another disconnect coming in. We'll just, don't know how long this one's going to take. But the second he reconnects in, I'm going to drag this bar straight back to the left. Nope, there we go. Straight back to the left, as I said. So back to 1 second time. Or one time speed. He should be back inside the game now. But this is a horrible position for him to be in. Double damage up on the Queen of Pain. Alex is there. We've got Wisp looking for an ultimate. standing right next to him and can bring black in at a moment's notice. So there's the go call. We just sick already cast what he's got. Now Alex, see what he can do. Tombstone to drop. He's trying to buy a little bit of space for Fader. Quap Baldy. Alex, oh, he uses Soldier to keep his Fader alive. But lost his own life, and there's a jump in behind. You looked more for Kuro as well as Black. Now moving over towards Ace. Double damage or not, he's still going to go down. And Kuro should sever the tether right now so he can get himself out of here safely. Weaver looked for it, and he did sever it. And then heading down south, the Tier 1 tower will go down the mid. And Kuro's caught up on the top lane. This will be mid tower going down. Undying. Well, I suppose he wanted to keep Fader alive, but could have soul ripped himself to stay alive just then. Queen of Pain was focusing on him. And now, oh, Coddle. Yep, they just passed each other. They could see each other quite clearly. And that's why support's coming up. TP out, Fader can't finish him. Not in time. And then down towards the bottom lane. And he is going to build up towards a Lincoln Spear. Very, very defensive style item. Incoming. And then up towards the top lane again. Graver Little Courier brings in. So we got Armlet and 1300 gold up on Black. Kuro no ultimate right now, but he doesn't really need it. All he wants to do is just tether and give Black that opening. Yep, there's the open wounds. Sars with the spirits. Whoop, a little bit of a time, but look at Kuro's position. Perfect for those spirits to come in and bring him down on the way back out again. Kuro, however, taking up that tower. He's going to go down. A little bit over commitment there, and now Black is caught out of position. He dived in too far himself. Might have to rage himself out of this one for a moment. He's got one of those little scarab things on his tail, but then raging up and infesting zone and creep wave. Support's coming up. It's already Alex on the way, looking for a decay. And there's no mana up the sleeve for Weaver. He can't cast his ultimate right now. Even with those stick charges, he didn't have enough. And Paz gets more space in that bottom lane. Here in the Rockets. Oh, that's a little bit too short for the Shadow Demon. We need to pop off another one as well to hit that. And there wasn't enough time really to kill off the SD. Not with the amount of damage he'd already taken. We need to take more than that to get the kill. And now Fader, heading down towards that bottom lane. Invis rune in hand, so just looking for one person that's out a little bit too far from the tower. What is actually our advantage right now? Yeah, okay. 10,775K. Going the way of Mouse Sports, IC Cup really not having that much success. And this could be another reason why. Queen of Pain now DC's out. But on the power of the replay, there's none of this long wait. Whoop, oh, reconnect back in again. Back to one speed. And the resuming of the game. So good to go. And Alex with Arcanes. Is that something else flying out to him? Mech charge just yet? No, just observe it wards. Doesn't really have that much gold by the looks of it. Yeah, because there is 11 for 0 on the last hits. Not a hell of a lot, but it's 19 for 7. And they've claimed 2 tier 1 towers. Now in the bottom lane, they're searching for the Weaver, and they find him too. Remember, he's got the ultimate, but then again, they keep him stunned! No time to trigger the ultimate. 3 TPs come down, they're looking for pass. Impale stun will hit, but then again, Viper slowing down J4, and Wisp TPing in, brings in Black, and just opens up with the infest damage. Pass still alive in this engagement, and that tether does its job. Shadow Demon gets stunned instantly, and looks like someone else is still here. Cotter with a blast, almost enough to kill off pass. But we'll lose his own life for it. Kuro leaves the engagement, goes back up towards that top lane, and the tier 1 tower goes down. This is just great rotation from Mouse Sports everywhere they go. And now 3k gold up on the Nakes. So we look to see his Desolator coming up very, very shortly. Kuro maybe going to get himself out of this top lane as Weaver comes up. But again, it's this Perseverance. Gives him mana as well as health to play around, but all of his damage comes from that Ring of Aquila as well as from those agility treads. And that's it. I think Black just forgot to use his Hand of Midas for a moment, which is kind of weird for Black. Black's one of those guys that will make the most of everything. Oh, Alex. There's an Invis Vendetta. Coming in behind J4. Looks for the first hit. Nanda's done out in Fader. Oh, Quap Baldy. Now the Soul Rip does its job. Keeps Fader alive. He gets a nice amount of damage off onto Axe. And Axe will go down. That's a big, big Alex. Another set of decay. He tanks up the entire Cotton Blight. He's got so many levels of decay. He's got 6 up in him right now. And Black comes in. Disruption will save the life of Shadow Demon for the moment, but there is another Soul Rip. Alex almost dead, will go down. Weaver doing that job. The Black trying to man up for the moment. Clockwork Goblin, Aldi's down into Black, and then holds the Weaver in position, but he's in range of the tier two tower, so he's copying too much damage right now. Mini Stuns or not, neck charge as well. Rocket not going to be anywhere near enough. Triple kill comes the way of the Weaver. And that's going to go a long way to completing up that Lincoln Spear. And Kuros is like, what the hell did my team just do? What the hell did they just do? DP's in towards that middle lane now, so Fader. Look at Aghanim Scepter already. Ridiculous, ridiculous cooldown time. Can pop that thing off like three different times. Kuro, this time it's his turn to get caught out. So Mousesports throwing the game like a boss. And Fader's going to make his way in towards the mid lane too. See if he can find out Ouija Sick. He's got three of himself too, so Ouija Sick will have no idea who to go on. Two go high, he goes in, and then Keeper of the Light. Blinding Light will save him a little bit, but then the Disruption's also there. More than enough time for Fader to get one more right click in. In fact, it's all the fakes of Fader that's doing the job. Undying throws down the Tombstone. Well, got to be a little bit more careful with that Spike Carapace. Won't take it too much. An Axe jumping out through the top. At the same time, Weaver continues to add. That's a decent creep wave on the bottom. It might even be enough to bring down the Tier 2 tower. In fact, it will be if there's no support that comes. So it'll be a Tier 2 for a Tier 2 if Mousesports want to try and force this. But they've got Fortification. Yeah, there's Fortification. And there's the TP already. Black is the one coming in. And he's happy to steal all that farm. And he actually goes Orchid instead of going to go for the Desolator. So looking for the Silence, not a bad item considering he is going up against both Weaver as well as Quap. Both heroes and SD and Coddle. In fact, it's great against every single spellcasting hero of ICC Cup. Which is what made Nakes just such a logical and great pickup from Mousesports. Because you realize, like, you pop into Rage and then ICC Cup do no damage whatsoever. Kuro, not a fan of trees. Blink away from Max. Give as much momentum towards this top lane as possible. And then in towards middle lane. Ulti in from Black as well as Kuro. And, well, Disruption will buy him a little bit of time. Kuro should be tethering this tether in just a moment. There's support coming in as Weaver is here, and Kuro will get himself out of safety. And then Black opens up. Look at those cogs, just pushing him back, and again, time-lapse. There's only just enough time for a Quap holding out, but Pass with a mech charge will keep himself up, and now Black goes for the next for support hero. While Axe gets pushed back, Pass tries to get himself through his own cogs, but not going to happen. And maybe now they can kill off Black. Axe, he's just getting bumped around by these cogs. And there's your Orchid. And Tether back in again. Kuro rejoining the engagement. And that's Weaver dead. Axe also still here in the engagement. He's completely out of mana and then locked in position after that Tether stun. There's a triple kill over to Black. And 13 to 32 now up on the board. Good to see people winning prizes as well by watching the defense. Good to see. Call to blast. Kuro's going to be careful about that one, but he just walks off to the side. He's got Tranquil Boots anyway. He'll tether up with Black and then just give him the heal. So they can go back in again. Oh, Black. Nice armor manipulation. Soul Rip for a moment. And pass him, Black. In fact, the entire team, mech charge, everybody gets heal. I think that's what they're actually waiting for, because you're going to get the double heal out from the mech. Up towards top of lane, Fader. Already slowed down a hell of a lot. Captured, purged, whatever they've got. Rockets to fly, but look at him just tank it up like a boss, and then support comes in from Black. Easy turn around to pick off J4, and then just moving on to We Just Sick. Way too much damage. Coddle blast through, and there goes Kuro out, but in comes Pass in. And then Kuro just tethers himself back into the engagement. Doesn't want to miss a single thing. It's not as though he's got like an urn he's trying to fill up or something. He's got 2.1k gold he gets to spend right now. Black's now up to 3.2k. And Fader 2.6 after what he's got. There's finding kills everywhere on the map.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And now Mousesports back in towards that middle lane to push out the tier 2 tower in mid. So easy to do. Rockets fly down, get a nice little bit of vision. Already spotting out that Coddle inside his ghost form. Comes back out of it now, so he won't have that option. Has to channel the old-fashioned way. As a law! Blast up the middle lane. Blight doesn't care, he just rages, and then fortifications also forced out. Clockwork Goblin Rocket keeping those supports a little bit lower. And while Weaver's going out through that bottom lane, we know Kuro's got ulti, so the second he tries to push on that tier 2 tower, they just like combine up with Black. Ulti now flies out from Viper, and he can throw this out every like 10 or 12 seconds. Clock jumps in, now the Kosh can go, pushes Ace back into the fight, and he gets silenced instantly, so there was no blinking back out again. Alex trying to keep himself alive by Soul ripping up, and Weaver rejoined this engagement. Actually, no, that's the Vendettering NA who walks in range of a Sentry Ward. Weaver takes the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane instead. And now we'll lose the tier 2 tower in the mid. And Black, Orchid's off cooldown. Kuro and Black can go for a trip. And they can bring him down the bottom lane. I think Kuro's currently considering it. It's a tier 3 tower race right now. Weaver versus the entire Mousesports side. I think I know who I'm going to put my money on. Coddle Blast, going to slow him down a little bit. Decent chunk of damage. The tower does go down. How's that bottom lane looking? Weaver, bring it down to half-life. Mid-drag should happen. Yeah, here we go. That's that ulti up. They're searching for the Weaver. He's already tricking himself inside the corner. They kind of feel it too. Time-lapse is up. They know exactly where he is. And then nice repositioning here coming out from the Weaver. Kuro and Black will not catch up in time. But they just jump straight back into the engagement. Clock might be on the sidelines, but the reinforcements arrive. And then all of a sudden, it just gets wiped. 4 euros lost, and then Connor will buy back. And Weaver rejoins. He TP'd himself back in here. Lincoln Spear is there, so at least it triggers one thing. But it's a right click from Fader to get rid of it. And then he ulties up Coddle. Look at that damage just flying in from Fader. Tick over. Now moves over. Orchid on the Weaver. No time lapse on cooldown anyway, so he can't do it. Mousesports will take the mid. And Black on such low life, but that's just the armlet. And GG, well played. It comes out from FNG. Looks like someone remained in the game to the very, very bitter end. What was the call? Yeah, they wanted to keep on fighting this one out. But that is most definitely GG well played. Weaver has already left the game. So I shall also do the same. Corp all in creep waves. Absolutely fantastic. All right, guys, that is the end of that game. So, a game which I missed while I was over in Malaysia. ICC Cup going up against Mousesports. I think there's actually one other game too, which I might be able to broadcast for you, which I missed. The other one was 4FC going up against NextKZ. So that is the other matchup. We're still got another 45 minutes beforehand. I might actually take a bit of a break before we do that. But hey, ICC Cup going up against Mousesports. That's what we just had. That was one of the games I missed. And hey, we'd ever like you to miss some stuff. So there you go. We'll be back, guys. We'll be back.
Said good day, sir!